Hello, thank you for your interest in our paper entitled Interferon Gamma-Related mRNA Profile Predicts Clinical Response to PD-1 Blockade, published in the Journal of Clinical Investigation. My name is Terri McClanahan, and I'm the Executive Director of Profiling and Expression at Merck Research Labs. And I'm joined today by my colleague and co-author, Jared Lunceford, distinguished scientist in biostatistics. On behalf of all of our co-authors and Merck, we're pleased today to highlight some of the key aspects of our paper, as well as give you a glimpse inside the laboratory where we perform these analyses. The analyses we performed utilized pre-treatment tumor samples from patients with various cancers in clinical studies with an anti-cancer drug known as pembrolizumab. Pembrolizumab is a monoclonal antibody that disrupts the interaction of the programmed death 1, or PD-1, receptor and its ligands PD-L1 and PD-L2. While therapies that target the PD-1 pathway have been shown to improve survival in some cancers, not all patients will benefit from PD-1 blockade. As we learn more about how tumor cells interact with immune cells within the tumor microenvironment, we can gain a better understanding of why patients may or may not respond to certain anti-cancer therapies. For example, studies have shown that patients with tumors that express PD-L1 may be more likely to respond to anti-PD-1 therapies, such as pembrolizumab. However, PD-L1 is only one component of a much more complex network within the tumor immune microenvironment. There are likely many other genes or markers that can be used to identify patients who have a high likelihood of responding or not responding to a specific treatment. Newer technologies are now available that allow us to expand beyond a single marker and further evaluate the complexities of tumor and immune cell interactions. Let's go inside the laboratory so that we can show you one of these new technologies that we use to assess gene expression levels from human patient samples. Formalin-fixed paraffin-embedded clinical tissue specimens are first assessed for tumor content. Then a 5-micron section is used to isolate total RNA. The number of slides needed depends on the size of the specimen, but it was typically 2 to 4 slides per case. For measuring gene expression, 50 nanograms of total RNA was hybridized to bar-coded bead sets on the NanoString nCounter gene expression platform, using a set of 680 genes, and scanned on the nCounter digital analyzer.
Using the techniques Terri just described, we're able to count the messenger RNA transcripts of genes in pretreatment tumor tissue and search for sets of genes or signatures which will predict outcome under treatment with pembrolizumab. We followed a stepwise, rigorous statistical approach to identifying a signature that predicts outcome to pembrolizumab. In summary, we started by looking at expression profiles in a small pilot cohort of 19 patients with melanoma. From this very first group, we found that the top genes correlated with response to pembrolizumab were directly linked to interferon gamma signaling and expression. Interferon gamma is a key cytokine produced by activated T cells and directs several signaling pathways within the tumor microenvironment, including upregulation of PD-1 pathway. As more clinical trial data became available, we continued to refine and validate the gene expression profile in a larger melanoma cohort and other tumor types, starting with head and neck and gastric cancer. Ultimately, a statistical approach was used to select an 18-gene signature that predicted objective response to pembrolizumab, using the data from 9 different types of solid tumors as input. The clinical utility of the final signature is being further evaluated in ongoing pembrolizumab trials. The final 18-gene signature has been named the T-cell-inflamed gene expression profile. Inspection of the genes in the profile suggests that a subset of tumors from diverse tissues of origin exhibit a common, ongoing, adaptive, and cytotoxic T-cell response, including interferon gamma signaling, cytolytic activity, antigen presentation, and T cell trafficking, as well as inhibitory mechanisms that are evident in T cell homeostasis. As mentioned earlier, PD-L1 expression is also associated with response to anti-PD-1 therapy. To understand the potential clinical utility of the T-cell inflamed gene expression signature, we tested the final signature in an independent set of head and neck cancer patients and compared performance against that of PD-L1 as measured by immunohistochemistry. Statistical testing in this independent cohort of head and neck cancer patients confirmed the T-cell inflamed gene expression profile was significantly predictive of outcome under pembrolizumab treatment. We compared the ROC curves of the T-cell inflamed signature and PD-L1 expression via immunohistochemistry. The area under the ROC curve for the T-cell inflamed signature compared favorably with that for PD-L1 expression via IHC, suggesting that a multivariate approach using gene expression analysis might offer benefits in sensitivity to detect responders to anti-PD-1 therapies. Finally, across multiple tumor types, we observed a general pattern of a lack of objective response in patients whose tumors show low expression levels across the genes. In the figure, the T-cell inflamed signature score is compared to progression-free survival for 244 patients across 9 different tumor types, with tumor objective response labeled. From this plot, you can see that patients whose tumors had scores less than -0.3 generally did not achieve response, and as a group showed rapid disease progression despite treatment with pembrolizumab. Conversely, a broad spectrum of responses and progression times were observed for higher scores. These data suggest that the presence of a T-cell inflamed phenotype is necessary but not always sufficient for clinical response to PD-1 inhibition.
Ultimately, as Jared has described, we derived an 18-gene expression profile that correlates with response to pembrolizumab across a wide variety of tumor types. The genes included in the signature suggest a complex biology of immune cell homeostasis in anti-PD-1 responsive tumors. This signature provides a simple quantitative measurement of the complex immune milieu in the tumor, and our data suggests that integrated multi-gene signatures might represent an additional valuable tool to successfully bring anti-PD-1 therapy to cancer patients most likely to benefit. The T-cell inflamed gene expression profile has undergone analytical validation on the NanoString platform and is under development as a clinical grade diagnostic device being evaluated in ongoing pembrolizumab trials. We invite you to dive deeper into each of the rigorous analytical validation steps we used to derive this 18-gene T-cell inflamed signature by reading our article. And on behalf of all of my co-authors, I thank you for your time and attention.